With the Lung Foundation's 30-year celebrations and other major events cancelled this year, we're excited to be presenting the Lifetime Achievement Awards and the inaugural Lung Health Awards virtually this year. These awards recognise individuals who've made a significant contribution to improving the lives of people impacted by lung disease and by lung cancer. We recognise Jenny for her passion in improving the management options and increasing access to pulmonary rehabilitation, in particular for people living with chronic lung disease. Jenny has had a long and very distinguished commitment to the Lung Foundation, to patients and to their families, and we congratulate her for her work and for the receipt of this award.
I'm really touched by this award. I love working with Lung Foundation Australia. It's a terrific organisation that's never lost sight of the fact that patient and patient support and patient care is the centre of their work. And working with the people at Lung Foundation Australia is an absolute pleasure. They are such a hugely committed team, and I've loved every minute of my time working with you all. So a big thank you for this award.
Tam is recognised for her dedication to research and clinical outcomes for people with interstitial lung disease, idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis in particular. Tam has been a leader in this space. Tam, thank you for your work for the Lung Foundation and for people with interstitial lung disease, and congratulations on receiving this award.
I'd just like to say a big thank you to the Lung Foundation Australia. It's a real privilege to work with the Centre of Research Excellence for Pulmonary Fibrosis, and this award will encourage me and others to keep going in our work together to try and improve the lives of patients with pulmonary fibrosis in Australia. Thank you.
We recognise Adam for his tireless commitment to children with rare lung diseases and children with asthma. Adam is an active member of the Lung Foundation's rare lung disease committees and task forces, and he frequently appears on behalf of families and children with rare lung diseases and with asthma, and has been an articulate spokesperson for their cause.
Wow, what an honour it is for me to receive one of the inaugural Lung Health Legend Awards. You know, I've always told my wife that she's living with a legend, and now it's official. This award represents the mammoth team effort it has taken to improve the lives of the children and the families that we look after with rare lung disease. I'd particularly like to acknowledge the parents of children with interstitial lung disease with whom I've worked. It has been my privilege. I'd also like to acknowledge Lung Foundation Australia. Thank you for everything that you have done in supporting, helping improve the lives of the children that we look after. So receiving the award, thank you very much again. I am truly humbled.
We recognise Quan Phong for his long dedication to the care and better outcomes for people with lung cancer. He has been working in this space for the whole of his career and has made some major advances in lung cancer research.
2020 and the coronavirus has reminded us all around the world how important lung health is. It is therefore an incredible honour to receive one of these prestigious Lung Foundation Australia Awards this year. I feel especially fortunate and humbled to receive this award, but the real legends are the people affected by lung diseases, their families and their carers, as well as Lung Foundation Australia, who have for 30 years strived to bring us all together, to work together to improve lung health and to reduce the impact of lung diseases.
Christine McDonald has been awarded a Lung Health Legend Award for her dedication to improving access to treatment and care for people with COPD. Christine has had a very long commitment to the COPD-X guidelines in particular and the COPD Coordinating Committee, and has delivered many, many presentations to health professionals and to patients.
Good afternoon. When I was told that I was being honoured by the Lung Foundation with this award, I was surprised and delighted. Thank you all so much. I've watched the Lung Foundation grow and develop to the point where it's now an absolutely outstanding organisation, providing the focal point for lung health advocacy and support in Australia. Of particular importance has been its recognition of the need to involve patients or consumers in all aspects of its advocacy, including at local, state and federal levels. Patients are key in all the LFA programs and are also increasingly actively involved in research as an integral part of the research team. This is so important. In my career in medicine, I've always kept the individual patient and their needs at the forefront of my mind in both my practice and my research, and I'm truly proud to be strongly associated with an organisation that does the same.
It's a great pleasure to present this award to Wes. Wes has given unique support to Lung Foundation Australia over many years in his professional capacity. Wes's commitment to patients with chronic lung disease and COPD and interstitial lung disease in particular, but to the Lung Foundation much more broadly, has been something we have valued immensely and has made a significant difference to the offerings that the Lung Foundation has been able to make to health professionals and to patients. And it's a great pleasure, Wes, to announce this award for you and to be giving it to you.
In accepting this award, I would really like to thank the Lung Foundation and its board for this truly great personal honour. As a long-standing advocate and passionate supporter of lung health, it's been an exciting journey to observe the Lung Foundation over the last 30 years become this amazing peak organisation that it is today. So as well as offering my thanks, I would also like to congratulate the Lung Foundation for all that it's achieved. Thank you very much.
Sue has been a member of Lung Foundation Australia's COPDX Guidelines Committee since 2005. She, along with many of the other physiotherapists, has been committed to developing the resources available to people in the pulmonary rehab programs. We recognise Sue's significant contribution to the lives of people who have chronic lung disease, and in particular COPD, over these years. Congratulations, Sue.